job in the same position. I've wrestled guys before, though. They wouldn't react at all to the thing, don't worry. I'd even touch their leg. If you can get them to where you're tapping their leg and they're not reacting, flat. Just take your shot. They're not reacting to any of your setups. You gotta go. You got two choices. You can set the man up, but if he doesn't react to anything, no setups, it's gonna work. So then you fake the setup. It's going to be a fake fake. Right? And that's how it works. You see guys go fake, fake, fake. This way the man never knows what's coming. I've wrestled guys that have faked me for half a match. I just sit there and go, man, after a while, I'm like, yeah, that fake. It's not a bad way to go. Anyway, there's some thoughts on setups. I'll show you some little tricks I have. Get by a guy's hands. Just a little stuff. Okay, this is one I like. I've been playing. I'm here, the guy's waiting for the shot. And this is actually out of martial arts. I just thought, you don't really need, like, you misdirect, keep him from being inside my arm. I don't really need to push it out of the way. All I need is this. Right? I mean, I'm inside. As long as I shoot now, he can't stop with his arm. So I'm here. I just slap him. Or, this is the toe. For the guy that the shoulder blocks you every time. Like this, okay? That's the toe. Okay, we know a guy that's his whole repertoire of wrestling. He's got thumbs. This is big. He's very good at that. So anyhow, I've got an inside tie or whatever it is I want to attack with, and he thumb blocks. What I'll do is go up to him. Let him thumb block me right here. I'll just pop him. Pop it out. And that's what I do. High arm, I pop this way. Low arm. And this is, I've already got something to attack for this side, whether it be an underhook, inside tie, elbow, whatever. It'll work with an elbow tie right here. He's waiting right now. If I shoot right now, this is how you block the enemy's attack. I'm going to block my arm, and if I'm lucky, I'll get out of there with my head. If I'm unlucky, he'll choke me out. I'll tell the ref. Okay, so I'm not going to shoot on top of his arm. It's not going to help me. I've got to figure out a way to get through his arm. I can cut where he can reach. And I can do that intermediate time thing. Or I can pop right there. That's it. Now, look, he's got to raise his arm over mine to get back inside, and it's too late. Just a quick rule. Okay, you go under a man's arm. Okay, and that's how a real good friend of mine, he's a little big champ. He could fake a shot. That was his big thing. He'd go, huh, and he got to block it. Right? What he really had to do was an elbow post. That's why he didn't shoot. He'd go, shoot. Right there. Double elbow post, double leg. He did it much better than I did. That's what he did. Here. It almost looked like one shot. He wasn't doing this. Bang, back, post. Okay, and that's what you're going to find on all your timing and almost all your moves of wrestling. There's going to be like a certain cadence or whatever you have to use to make your setup work. You have to allow the reaction time. Okay, if I just go set up chop too fast, it doesn't give the guy time to react. Right? I'll end up, like, say I did this. This is the face snap down to a shot. Say I did this. And shot right now. I just run right into his head. Right? I'm going to go here, and I'm going to wait until I feel he's coming up. Right? If I don't do that, we'll hit him. Alright, so elbow post. That's going under the arms. That's another way to get into a guy. You can elbow post one arm, you can elbow post two arms. You can elbow post from underhooks and all kinds of things. All the elbow posts. Both hands, like you're going to push away on the guy. Thumbs out. Catch here. Drop your elbow to push. And it's important to drop your elbows. If you're trying to push like this, you don't have any strength. You like trying to do a military press here. I go into about 300,000. Strong, you can do this with your elbow. Elbows. You watch the break, brother. They'll run a guy across the mat with an elbow post. They'll just grab the arm, hold it up in the air, run. Okay, that's all. Elbow post. Warrior in the arms. You can go around the arms. That's an arm break. Okay? Go around the outside of the arms to attack. Same main guard, left arm, left arm. It was modern here. He had to show arm drag. He taught me an arm drag when I was 16. Can't do it. Here, you do it like this. Alright, outside step. That's so I can attack you. This is to get an angle. Come here. I'm going to be attacking this way. And if you didn't catch Mr. Modder's clinic, one of the things he taught me when I was 16 or 17 was to get my arm out of the way. I'll pull the arm across. Okay? Right now my arm circles around the ends and I come in. That's how he does it. He believed that you could drag both sides for four times as effective. Some kind of mathematical thing. No, I can't drag those sides, so I won't count. One for one. That's what I'm talking about. Alright, now another way to go outside of your arms. This is an arm drag. Here, I'll show you a little trick my Bulgarian friend taught me. You don't know him, but he's pretty good. Okay, on an arm drag, I really like this. Instead of stepping in the middle, the way I was taught, he sweeps the far foot. I've gotten a lot more on drag since I started doing that. And it just stumbles the guy a little bit. He comes here. Okay, it's a little different twist for you. Right here. I'll even force that. Just grab the guy's wrist like this. Come here. Step. Okay. So that's a drag to get around the outside of the arm. Slide by. It almost there's a post too. This was a post going under, there's a post where you go outside. Just like that. That instead of really going under, the arm just shoved it off to the side. That's a type of post where you take the arm sideways. Okay, so go under the arms, around the side of the arms. What else? Guys, what? What's that? I never should have said that. But the chop was almost the same way as a fake drag. You either try to catch him in the medium top, the medium top, or he grabs you again like this one. If you reach for you again. Or you stumble them forward. Okay, like that. And then you want to follow his hands in for the